In the work that we've been doing on face perception, one of the big questions we have is why are some people good at recognizing faces and why are some less good, to be polite about it? What we know right now is almost nothing. There's all sorts of theories that are out there. We've actually made some discoveries recently that help us kind of understand what might be one of the really key elements. Where we're hoping to go is be able to use that to develop training paradigms. So we can help people, for example, people with on the autism spectrum or people who have certain sorts of brain disorders like prosopagnosia. We want to be able to help those people recognize faces better. One of the techniques we use is electroencephalography, which is often known as EEG. And it's basically we are able to sort of put electrodes on top of somebody's head and measure the electricity that's sort of flowing through their skull as a result of their brain activation. And then we look to see how does that change as a function of what the stimulus is, the age of the person, what they've learned, and so on. So we're using a variety of techniques and we try to fit everything together to make sense of it. The more we understand what the critical elements are, the more we can develop those kind of personalized training programs to make everyone good at this, or at least a little bit better. Because face perception is so critical for our everyday lives. We're seeing some really transformational approaches to what's going to be happening and how we can bring our work from the laboratory into the real world.